So this is the continuation of lecture number 24, and in this part of the lecture I will discuss about the power and torque curves. The power curve of a wind turbine is a graph that is indicating how large the electrical power output will be for the turbine at various wind speeds. The reason is that the in practice the wind speed is always fluctuating, and one cannot measure the exact speed for a certain time limit, and one is not able to measure exactly the column of the wind that passes through the rotor of the turbine. In reality, these curves are not as smooth like shown over here. In reality, if we see a real curve for a active operating wind turbine system, you will see a swarm of points that is spread around the line and not the neat curve like in these graphs. The reason being that in practice the wind speed is always fluctuating, and one cannot measure exactly the column of wind that is passing through the rotor of the turbine. So it is not a workable solution just to place an anemometer in front of the wind turbine, since the turbines will have a cost like a wind shadow and break the wind in front of itself. In practice, therefore, one has to take an average of the different measurements for each wind speed and plot the graph through these averages. Furthermore, it is difficult to make exact measurements of the wind speed itself if one has a 3% error in the wind speed measurements. Then the energy in the wind may be 9% or higher or lower. Remember that the energy content varies with the third power. It was the cube, as it was shown in the formula, it was related to the cube of the wind speed. Consequently, there may be errors for the small variations in the measurement of wind speed might contribute to a relative error of plus minus 10 to 15%, and even in the certified curves for the given data sheets that is provided by the vendor. So here T1 max and the P1 max do not occur at the same wind speed. If we observe that on the x-axis it is the speed in radians per second. So for the maximum power and the maximum torque, the wind speeds are different. Similar is the case for the P2 max and the T2 max. So for the maximum power point tracking algorithm, the goal is to match the rotor speed to generate the power continuously that is close to the P max points. The change in rotor speed is done to arrive at a new Pmax point, because the Pmax point changes continuously with the changing wind speeds. The next important parameter is the tip speed ratio. The tip speed ratio, it will tell you that how many seconds it would take to make one revolution. The tip speed ratio is an extremely important factor in wind turbine design. The tip speed ratio refers to the ratio between the wind speed and the speed of the tips of the wind turbine blades. The further away from the center, the faster is the angular speed of the blade. So this is formula where omega is the angular rotor speed and r is the radius of the rotor, and v is the velocity or wind velocity, that is free upstream wind. The CP varies with the TSR as shown in the graph. The CP at the same wind speed has a CP max has a at the same wind speed will have a maximum power. The rotor must turn at higher speed in higher winds to extract maximum power, and vice versa, while the TSR must be kept constant. Now I will discuss about the basic important performance attributes that are related to the tip speed ratio. The first one is the maximum value of CP achieved to a particular value of TSR ranges from 1 to 6. The 1 is for the low speed turbines, and the 6 is for the modern two blade high speed turbine. The second performance attribute is the stress in the blade parameter proportional to TSR. The higher the stress, the higher the TSR. High stresses are present for the high tip speed ratio. The third is the ability of the wind turbine to start under load inversely proportional to TSR. Starting torque decreases as the TSR is basically tends to increasing. Next, I will discuss about the controlled operation of wind turbines. The goal is to operate the wind turbine at a constant TSR for close to maximum power point for maximum power point tracking algorithm to work properly. So, if this goal is achieved, that TSR is kept constant, the windmill is capable of generating 20 to 30% of more energy per year. To achieving this goal, there are two schemes which are implemented. The first one is the constant tip speed ratio scheme, and the second one is the peak power tracking scheme.